Ripley, welcome back.
Thank you.
I want to start this conversation by going back to WrestleMania 40, because you've enjoyed at that time this year-long dominant reign as the women's world champion on Raw. You successfully defend that title at WrestleMania, and the Judgment Day really looks as strong as ever. Take us back to the high that you were riding at that time.
Man, it's hard to put the emotions that were going through everyone into words, because Judgment Day, we were on top. We ran WWE. Everything was so perfect, and we were all so happy.
And then Liv shows up, injures your shoulder, takes you out. You have to relinquish the very championship that you had been holding so proudly for so long, and you have to go home and leave your boys on their own. How would you describe your mental state at that time?
It was honestly heartbreaking. It was depressing. It was scary in a way. We were at such a high. Then to have it all taken away in such a split second, get thrown into the brick wall, my shoulder, I don't even know what happened to my shoulder. It like exploded pretty much.
Did you know immediately that it was bad?
Oh, I knew. As soon as I got thrown into the brick wall, I felt my shoulder slip down and I grabbed it instantly and I could feel this massive like bulge, and that's where my bone was. I didn't want to believe how bad it was going to be, but once we rushed to medical afterwards and they started moving it around, they're like, no, it's not dislocated. We think it's worse. And to know that I was actually gonna have to sit down and like take some time, it pissed me off and it made me upset but hungry to get back in ring, and I'm there.
So is it safe to say that the shoulder is 100% going into this match against Liv Morgan?
Look, wrestling is unpredictable, especially going in there with someone like Liv Morgan, who I know very, very well. And I know that she's gonna try to target it.
Your history with her, it's well documented. You guys tagged together. You were one-time friends, I would say. She has obviously approached the last year as an eye for an eye. She comes back on this revenge tour. She takes you out of commission, puts you on the shelf, wants to take your title that you never lost, but she does win it. And then she set her eyes on your dom-dom.
I feel like it went too far. The way that she came into the Judgment Day and she started infiltrating our clubhouse and manipulating my boys is sick. If you got a problem with me, use your fists. Don't use my family. Don't use my dirty dom, my Latino heat. Don't try and take what is mine. You already took my Women's World Championship. You took months of my bloody career. When you bring family into it, it's always stepping too far.
How would you describe your relationship with Dom while you were away?
A little bit disappointing. These were the best couple of years of my life. I grew to love him. I did, and I think he grew to love me, and we've been there for each other. And then when I got injured, the communication sort of just like, it didn't stop completely, but it definitely slowed down. So I'm a little bit disappointed that we let it get to that point, but I always tried my best to make time for my dirty dom.
Well, when you did come back, you were very clear in communicating one thing to Dom, and that was to end whatever was going on between him and Liv. And he used the words in front of everybody in the middle of the ring, I hate you. Liv. Put Liv into tears. How would you describe the way you felt witnessing that transpire?
Extremely excited and aroused and happy. It made my heart skip a couple beats. I mean, you saw me afterwards. I gave him a nice kiss on the cheek, and then watching Liv cry and walk away brought a little bit of joy to my heart.
So it's been a lot of highs, a lot of lows for you since WrestleMania 40. What would you say your mindset is going in to this match against Liv Morgan?
My mindset is the same as it always is, and that's to bring the brutality. I can't wait to get my hands on her, because I'm gonna do a lot of things that I've been wanting to do for a while. I need to leave the ring with my Women's World Championship. Show everyone that mommy is still on top, that mommy and the Judgment Day still run Monday Night Raw, that they still run the WWE.
All right, well, thank you for the time.
No worries.